good morning class 11th. So let's continue the chapter which we are doing it from the book called Hornbill. That is Landscape of the Soul written by Nathalie Trogre. Right? So yeah, today we are going to read the second part of that chapter. We are on page number 36. Right now we have discussed about the artwork only, about that paintings, the Chinese and Europeans one. Then the Shanshui term, the mountain, water, yin, yang, what they describe, the middle void. All this we have discussed. Now we are going to discuss about this thing, getting inside outside art. Now getting inside outside art, this is the article written by Brinda Suri in Hindustan Times, 28 August 2005 she had written about it. Basically she had described about art rut here. She had described about this term art rut. What she really described in this, Brinda Suri, she had said that there are number of people, they are having no rights on their artwork. They are having no rights to be artists, No rights to be artists basically means there are a number of people, those who had no formal training of artwork, but their artwork is superb actually. They had not taken any formal training, but they think out of the box and they create something very interesting. And then even there is one example given of that rock garden. You might have heard about that, this rock garden in Chandigarh. You might have visited it there also. So she had even described about this also. So we are going to read that art. Getting inside outsider art. When French painter Jean Dubuffet mooted the concept of art rut in the 1940s. So Jean Dubuffet has came up with this term art rut in the 1940s. The art of the untrained visionary ways of minority interest. So the term is the art of the untrained artist basically. From its almost veiled beginnings, outsider art has gradually become the fastest growing area of interest in contemporary art international. So this is the most, we can say here, the fastest growing thing. This genre is described as the art of those, now understand, as the art of those who have no right to be artists, as they have received no formal training, yet show talent and artistic insight. So it says about, this is about of those artists, they are having no right to be artists, meaning they are having no formal education, but they are having their talent and artistic insight. Their works are a stimulating contrast to a lot of mainstream offering. So their work, we can say even the ones who are having the formal training and the ones, these people, those belong to the art world, they are having no formal training, but their works are also superb. Around the time Dubuffet was propounding his concept in India, an untutored genius was creating paradise. So it mentioned that when this Jean Dubuffet was coming to the India for this for propagating this art form, the art bread basically, for propounding this concept, already untutored genius was creating one kind of a paradise at that time. Years ago, the little patch of jungle that he began clearing to make himself a garden sculpted with stone recycled material is known to the world today as the rock garden at Chandigarh. So it's mentioned there that many, as it's this article written in 2005. And that Jean Dubuffet mentioned this term in the year 1940 here basically. And when he came to the India. So at that time a person, like many years ago, there was a person who was creating a little patch of jungle, clearing himself a garden sculpted with stone and recycled material, which is known as rock garden. You might have all seen that how the recycled things, how the materials have been used to beautify that place. It's 80-year-old creator director Nek Chand. So Nek Chand has created a rock garden. Is now hailed as India's biggest contributor to outsider art. So he's the most, we can say he was the one who was India's biggest contributor for this art form actually. The 50th issue, Spring 2005 of Raw Vision, so 50th edition, a UK-based magazine pioneer in outsider art publications, features Nek Chand and his Raw Garden sculpture, Women by the Waterfall on its anniversary's issues cover. So a UK-based magazine actually, right? Who worked on that outsider art publication, the cover page was covered by Nek Chand's rock garden, a picture that is that sculpture, Woman by the Waterfall, 50th edition, 50th edition issue basically, that anniversary issue was there. The notion of art bread or raw art was of works that were in their raw state as regards cultural and artistic influences. Anything. It's about that this art bread or raw art, it shows about the raw state or showing some cultural or artistic influences. Anything and everything. Now listen, anything and everything from a tin to a sink to a broken down car could be a material for a work of art, something nature has taken to dizzying heights. So mention about anything, any broken thing or like from a tin to a sink or even a broken down car. These materials can be used to showcase the talent of that art work. And Nathan had taken this in, he had done this and that's why he reached to that height. Recognizing his art as an outstanding testimony of the difference a single man can make when he lives his dreams. The Swiss Commission for UNESCO will be honoring him by way of a European exposition of his works. So Swiss Commission honored Nathan because he lived his dream alone. He made that rock garden and various other things also. Means the things which can't be used. The broken things. Even so you have seen the rock garden, the bangles are there. Right? From those bangles it has been prepared. So he has created that thing. The 5-month interactive show, Realm of Nature, beginning October, will be held at leading museums in Switzerland, Belgium, France and Italy. The biggest reward is walking through the garden and seeing people enjoy my creation, Nathan says. Now what he mentioned that 5-month interactive show was there, Realm of Nature, and it was about to start in the month of October at various places, in the museums, Switzerland, Belgium, France and Italy. So it's a very honor moment for Nathan, and even he mentioned that when I'm at Rock Garden and when people are enjoying my creation, I really feel happy, and that is the biggest reward for me. So this is about getting inside outsider art. So please, if you have not visited Rock Garden, when you have gone to Chandigarh, next time whenever you will go, please visit it. Very nice place to go. Like the, you will see that as it's mentioned about that women by the waterfall, from the bangles, from those things were there. So you will basically enjoy the things which are of no use. It has been created in a very beautiful manner. So discussion is about one of the broken things from a tent to a sink, even broken car. You can basically use the things. Like in today's time, if I would say that DIY is basically going on, do it yourself. Any broken thing or anything which is of not use, you can prepare some artwork out of it by showing your creativity and innovation. So same manner you need to see for it, right? So the question also here, what do we understand by the terms outsider art and art bread or raw art? That's we have discussed about it. No rights of the artist or the one who has think out of the box basically. Who was the untutored genius who created a paradise and what is the nature of his contribution to art? So we are talking about the nature and how he has made that rock garden in Chandigarh. And there are the few questions which we are going to do it. So you will see and then you will do this worksheet and you will send it to me. Thank you. God bless you.